Hi, welcome everybody. Great to have you. I'm here with Prabhakar from HCL. Nice to have you.
Thank you. Thank you, Frank. I'm Prabhakar Appana. I run the AWS ecosystem business unit globally, and I'm based out of London. Happy to be here, Frank.
That's great. So I run the Cloud Operations Competency, a competency that AWS launched in April of 2023, not too long ago, even though it feels like a lifetime ago. And you were one of our launch partners. So at this point, I really want to thank you for putting the commitment into the AWS partnership and to jump through all of those difficult hoops that we posed for you, the long checklist that we usually have here. So I really appreciate that for your commitment.
Thank you. Thank you.
And just for anybody that might watch this that is not yet familiar with the cloud operations in the AWS world, cloud operations includes five solution areas, which includes governance, observability, cloud financial management, compliance, and centralized ops management. And all of this together is what AWS recommends to their customers to adopt as an integrated cloud operational model. So, I have established that HCL is very good in cloud operations and that you're a strategic partner for AWS in that space. But I'd be curious, in the AWS lingo of superpowers, where do you see HCL superpowers for your AWS practice?
From an HCLTech perspective, I mean, the cloud operations has been the bread and butter business for quite some time. I mean, we are into this enterprise transformation business for the last 3 to 4 decades almost. So, and HCLTech is predominantly known in the infrastructure and cloud operations for various global clients. So we understand and we kind of know in terms of how to position the entire cloud operations with respect to the client conversations, right? So if you look at from an HCLTech perspective, we manage a Fortune 500 company's IT enterprise landscape. Mm-hmm. So we have seen various dimensions of IT landscape evolving, and there are various levels of maturity when you look at from a client perspective. There are some clients who wants to move from a level of maturity, level 1 to level 2, level 3, level 4, looking at the various dimensions of their internal adoption. So from an HCLTech perspective, the entire cloud operations competency or cloud operations that we call is a big horizontal capability, and encompassed by various tools, accelerators. I'll talk about more on the HCLTech Elastic Ops, AI Ops, mm-hmm. with AI, machine learning, and NLP. So it's multi-dimensional. So as we see,
I love your Elastic Ops offering. I think that's a really good one. So just a second ago, I gave the AWS definition of cloud operations with those five solution areas. I'd be super curious, does that match with the HCL definition of cloud operations? Because I know that there's always a little bit of variation in the market out there, but just wanted to make sure that we're aligned on the terminology there.
I mean, from a holistic perspective, it does match, right? So, but we do, end-to-end, the complete 9 yards in terms of the managing the enterprise IT landscape. So the way HCLTech looks at this entire operations is to make it a zero incident enterprise. So the concept, the underlying concept is zero touch provisioning, zero incident enterprise. So how do you make your operations more efficient in terms of making it zero incident is something ingrained into our solutions and the offerings that we do. So if you look at from a cloud competency perspective, it does involve various aspects, right? Your infrastructure provisioning as a service, your end-to-end user management, integrated command operations, desktop as a service, your end user computing concepts. So everything has various dimensions in terms of how do you manage that. So for each of that aspects, we have a centralized way of approaching it. And based upon the maturity of the client, we apply the formula in terms of enabling an efficient operations for the specific client. So it does align with, and that's why we quickly got onto the competency partnership as well, thanks to AWS as well. That adds an additional dimension and value, especially with the AWS relationship, right? We are a premier consulting partner, and we do have several engagements going on with various clients. So when the client looks at, okay, oh, the AWS has a cloud competency certification, HCLTech is part of that. And then it adds an additional dimensional value-added stuff saying that, okay, so whatever we discuss with the client, it comes with an authenticated background of making sure you have already reviewed and certified these things and good to go to the market. So it's like an additional provisioning and dimension which motivates and boosts the client for having any conversation with HCLTech.
Yeah, and this is sort of in aligned with the how competencies are structured as well, right? Like we check whether these solutions or these advices that you are giving to your customer are repeatable and are based on mechanisms that you have set in place and are well documented. And the excellence that you bring to one customer is going to be the same excellence that you bring to the second customer, or the third, or the 50th, or the 100th, right? So I really like that. So you touched a little bit about on Elastic Ops or some of the offerings there. Could you name a couple that you have that you're excited about?
Absolutely. So from an HCLTech, we have an offering on the entire Elastic Ops, right? So and which is the underlying principle is based on bringing the AI, artificial intelligence and machine learning into the operations and making an efficient provisioning for the client. So if you look at operations perspective, many of these are repeatable and the things which are repeatable can be automated, right? So how do you make sure those operations which are getting repeated can be automated and eliminated? So it reduces your cost, it reduces your effort, it improves your efficiency. So as part of HCLTech Elastic Ops and AI Ops, what we do is to identify those elements, to understand the issues and the root cause analysis that needs to be done. How can you bring in an intelligence, an artificial intelligence into it, and make it a zero-touch provision for the client? So the client doesn't have to worry about, there is a go-live happening, do I have to provision this server? No, there is infrastructure as a server, service, which is incubated into it, which automatically provisions. So you don't have to worry about the mundane task, but yet provide that intelligence and platform for the client where it becomes very easy. Mm-hmm. So we have looked at all those aspects. We looked at the aspects which can be automated. We looked at the aspects which needs a little bit of fine tuning with respect to complexity of the client landscape, and make sure those aspects happen with the easier provisioning. So these aspects, we bring it together to make it as a one compelling offering from an HCLTech perspective.
Yeah, no, that sounds really good. I'm curious. I feel like these days everything is an LLM and everything is Gen AI. There's a lot of terms being thrown around. I see from the AWS perspective an insane amount of different, like really exciting use cases. And I just wanted to check, do you see any kind of confusion, or where do you see the misconception, or do you think it's pretty clear out there?
I mean, it's not the confusion. Absolutely, you need to have the latest of the latest, right? Mm-hmm. That's, you as an IT service services company and a global partner, you need to have the latest of the latest to demonstrate the capabilities. Yeah. But not every client is like that. There is a various maturity levels for each of the client. So we apply the formula accordingly. Right? I mean, we are talking about generative AI being incubated in every dimensions of cloud operations. So do we see the traction in that? Absolutely, yes. But do you apply that for every client? Not. I mean, it depends upon, again, from each client complexity and the landscape. For example, we have global clients where we, pharmaceutical company and, a global pharmaceutical company, and we manage their entire IT cloud operations center, thousands of instances, provisioning, etc. There, you definitely require a sophisticated way of operations, dashboard, provisioning, etc. Right? So, and the other side of the spectrum, we do have clients, in the utility sector, public sector, and insurances, which might not have such huge landscape, mm-hmm. right? So, Do you have that cost heavy structure for them? No. So you need to apply the formula accordingly and pick up those aspects which helps the clients. But we always make sure it is there is a continuous integration, continuous deployment aspects brought in, and the best practices are incubated in that. So
yeah, and you mentioned the cloud financial management solution area as well, right? Like having that integrated in your solutions to fit the customer's needs is super important, and that's what we see, and that's why CFM or cloud financial management is part of the larger CloudOps model, and it's so integral. And it's very important, especially, you know, as of recent, it feels like it's a key, it's a heart of that cloud operations model. You've touched a little bit on your customers. So AWS is a very data-driven company. So I have your deals at my fingertips. I can look it up on the system, and I also looked at all of the reference case studies that you sent to us when you were validated for the competency. But maybe could you touch a little bit on the folks that maybe don't know your big deals or exciting customer opportunities that you have out there? Maybe touch upon a little bit on references or customers?
I mean, obviously, I can't name the customer, but we work with the various industry groups. So we are currently working on a large pharmaceutical conversations, a global client who is looking at revamping his IT landscape and bringing in more efficiencies because of the cost optimization. So they want to optimize the cost. And we have a client in Europe, primarily on the manufacturing side, who was looking to automate some of their supply chain activities, supply chain business. You know, we are working with them in terms of managing their global presence across the portfolio, right? So bringing in and creating a multi-structure element with a hub and spoke model and centralizing this as an integrated operational command center provisioned 24/7. So we do have such clients where we are currently working on, and you know, we manage that. And there is a client in Australia, and then you know, where we are working very closely, telco client, where we manage heavy infrastructure services provisioning. It's where who looks at you know, automating the entire infrastructure, zero touch provisioning, monitoring, and root cause analysis, and also publishing that into the dashboard 24/7. So we do that through integrated you know, command center operations from HCLTech, and we bring in those efficiencies and the commercial construct to the clients, because you know, you spoke about cloud financial management, which is very, very important. So while you get onto the bandwagon of the cloud, it also depends, it's also very important as to how do you manage your cost, right? So you know, what efficiencies would you bring in? Is there any cost optimization models that you know, that HCLTech can look at? Yeah, absolutely, yes. I mean, we focus on all those aspects and make it in a compelling proposition for the client, primarily from the cost management aspect. So we have FinOps, you know, differentiating tools. We have our integrated, you know, vulnerability management tool called Verity. It's where we apply that for various, you know, clients. And we have something internally, which we internally use within HCLTech, which is called Dry Eyes, for managing your entire integrated issues and services and related to the desktop, etc. So we built those differentiating solutions, accelerators, which we not only use internally, but also help global clients provision that. So, I mean, yeah, it's an exciting area.
So I feel like I already heard a couple of trends in the conversations. I think cloud financial management, zero touch provisioning, are some of the conversations that came up. But you speak to a lot of customers, and you have a lot of customers that are live, and you speak to a lot of customers out there of all different sizes, all different geographies. What are some of the common conversations? Are there any trends that you have observed recently that are interesting, that you feel like, you know, this is something that our customers are really trying to get help with, or that are posing questions to us as a consulting partner? Any trends?
Definitely. See, you're based upon the set of clients we have. You know, if you look at the, you know, the trend and the format, there are one set of clients who looks at automating things. So these are some of the aspects which could be automated. They don't want to spend time there. They want to spend time on how their business can generate more value, right? So this has become a, like this has become like a more like a de facto, you know, you need to have this, right, you know, kind of approach. So which becomes very important for a system integrator like us to make it an efficient process. Some of the clients look for a centralized command center operations where they don't want, they want to consolidate everything at one place and, you know, have an approach to deal that with rather than having multiple vendors, multiple clients, one set of clients and make it much more efficient. That's one aspect that we look at. And if you look at another trend, there are clients who are actually exploiting the generative AI and creating their own unique flavor into the market, mm-hmm, from a business perspective. For example, if you look at you know, financial services or insurance, you know, if I need to go and you know, buy an insurance policy, you have to go through a set of questions and all that. So how can that really be automated and provisioned for the customer agent, wherein he can help the client do it in a much more faster fashion, mm-hmm, right? So some of these are getting automated. So we are creating tools and snippets which the underlying infrastructure can take care and enable these clients drive and build business-centric approach into the market.
Yeah, that's what I see as well in cloud operations. You know, like getting developer productivity up is great for bottom line profitability, but for our partners that help customers go to market faster and implement those use cases faster and more secure and more reliable, those are the ones that help the customers really have impact on the top line as well and actually let them explore new use cases and adopt those kind of latest and greatest, what you were mentioning on, the latest and greatest that is currently in the market. So that's great to hear. So 2024 is coming up, and I know that a cloud year is usually like 5 years. Like, I feel like a cloud year is like 5 years in real time. But what do you see as kind of the most prominent trends in 2024, maybe in 2025?
I mean, you know, hands-on, I think generative AI is going to change a way we operate and do things. Right now, Adam's announcement on Amazon Q coming in and how that Amazon Q gets integrated with the various aspects of EC2, S3, your Connect, everything is getting integrated. So it's becoming a one single pane interface. So there are a lot of exciting, you know, enhancements and services which are being, you know, which are coming to the markets. I mean, we need to look at from industry perspective, every industry is different. So how this can be adopted to those industries is something we need to look at. I think what we also need to see from us is how do we make your own internal IT processes in terms of enabling with the right skill set, mm-hmm, and making it much more faster time to market. And you touch base about the developer productivity. Like, you know, we recently announced our partnership with AWS on the AWS Code Whisperer, mm-hmm, right? Bringing in the, you know, the developer productivity enhancements, how that can be incubated to drive more efficiencies to the client. So these are all the aspects that we'll see. We'll have more roadmap for the next couple of years, making it much more efficient process. And, you know, as I said, I spoke about that zero touch and zero incident enterprise, right? I think.
Yeah. Well, I'm excited for what you have in store for 2024. I am grateful for you to be a competency launch partner with us, and I'm grateful to have you in the competency. So excited for what's ahead. So thanks for coming. Thanks for the conversation. Really appreciate it.
Thank you, Frank.